Chapter 7, Beginnings. Dar returned to camp just after the day turned dark. He was greeted by the welcome smell of roasting meat. The hunters must have had a successful day even without his uncle. Dar hurried to his tent and found Kenuk sitting up on his sleep robe. Mora sat beside him. "I'm glad you're back, Dar," she said. Kenuk gave Dar a hard look from under his heavy brow ridges. "I told you to be here before dark." Dar removed the fox from his shoulder and handed it to Mora. "I know. I have something to tell you both." Kenuk ignored what Dar had said. "Only one? I'm surprised." "Two snares were empty," Dar said, "and one had held a half-eaten mangy fox. I had to throw it away." "So where's the fifth catch?" Kenuk asked. Dar did not return Kenuk's gaze. "I let a fox cub go." "What a wasteful thing to do," Kenuk said. "That fur is soft. Good for a hat, children's boots, lots of things." "Uncle, the fox was just a baby," Dar said. "It deserved a chance to grow up." His grandmother looked sharply at his uncle. Kenuk spoke to Dar but stared at Mora while he talked. "I think you acted foolishly, like a woman." Mora and Kenuk glared at each other in a way that Dar had never seen. Kenuk pulled himself away with effort and turned to Dar. "Did you reset the traps at least?" Dar spoke quickly to try to break the tension he didn't understand. "Yes, well, all but the last trap. I was about to reset it when something happened." "What happened?" Kenuk demanded. Dar took a deep breath. "I met a stranger just after I released the cub. He was a man of your age, Uncle." Kenuk jerked his head up. "What was he doing in our territory?" "I don't know," Dar said. "We couldn't understand each other. He was dressed in fur, and his spear point was made of antler." "Dressed in fur?" Mora asked in alarm. "Did he seem dangerous? Were you frightened of him?" "At first, and he was frightened of me. I startled him," Dar said. "He had his spear ready to throw. I offered him some of my deer meat to show I meant no harm. He tried to start a fire with his fire sticks, but it was so misty in the forest they wouldn't work, so I used my fire rocks and got a fire going." Kenuk nodded impatiently. "Then what happened?" "He had never seen a sunstone before, and he wanted it." Kenuk's face tightened, but Dar continued, his voice filling with enthusiasm. "Then he showed me something I've never seen. It's a rod made of antler with a beautiful horse carved on it. I call it a spear thrower because when a spear is attached to the hooked end of the rod, it makes the throw longer and faster than a spear thrown without it." Kenuk spoke in a sneering tone. "And how do you know what the spear thrower can do?" Dar leaned forward. "He showed me how it works. With the spear thrower, his spear went twice as far as any I've ever seen. And he's a short man, Uncle, and not as strong as you." Kenuk said nothing for a long time. Then he shook his head. "It's not our way." Dar looked at his uncle's scowling face and had trouble forcing out the words. "It's a better way." Kenuk's eyes darkened. "You didn't trade your grandfather's sunstone for it, did you?" "No, Uncle, I didn't," Dar said, "but maybe I should have." "I can't believe you even considered doing such a thing," Kenuk said angrily. "The sunstone is mine to trade," Dar said. "Grandmother gave it to me." "You don't deserve to have it," Kenuk said, his voice rising. "It was my father's. If she'd given it to me, I would never let it go." Kenuk's eyes closed briefly. "Leave me. I don't want to listen to your childish talk." Without a word, Dar left the tent. He paused outside and heard his grandmother and uncle talking in low, angry voices. Dar walked to his favorite boulder and sat on its smooth face. In the cold night, it still held the warmth of the sun. Dar sat hugging his legs, his chin resting on his knees. After a while, Mora came out of the tent holding a beaver fur cape around her shoulders, with one hand and an animal fat lamp with the other. "Come back and sleep, grandson. You've had a long day." Dar made no move to leave the rock. He looked at Mora and saw for the first time how bent her back was and how gnarled and mishapen her fingers were. Dar had always thought of his grandmother as strong and vital. He had refused to see that she was aging. "Why did you and Uncle get so angry at each other?" Dar asked. "It seemed to start when I told him about the fox cub." Mora put her lamp on the boulder and sat next to Dar. It goes far back, just before you were born. Your father had just been killed. Your mother was sorrowing and weak, not eating enough. It was a difficult time for the clan. Hunting was poor. We were going to move camp as soon as you were born. Your birthing was hard. The clan waited for your mother to recover, but she never got back on her strength and never got up from her sleep robe. Dar shivered in the cold night. And then she died? Yes, and your uncle was sure you couldn't live without her milk, Mora said. He didn't want a sickly newborn without father or mother to be a part of the move to a new camp. Dar had never heard this part of his story. What happened? I argued with him, Mora said. I told him we should break camp at once, and that I would be responsible for you as well as for doing my share of the work. I prepared a special gruel of ground roots, eggs, and honey, and fed it to you whenever you cried. It was a long and difficult walk. No one thought you would live through it, but you did. Dar was silent for a long time. Finally, he said, "So he was angry at me for being a crying, demanding baby, interfering with the plans of the clan?" Mora turned her head away. Kanuk never said that. Dar thought of something for the first time. "Why did you give the sunstone to me instead of Uncle?" "You had lost so much," Mora said, "both mother and father. I wanted to give you something from your past. When you were put in charge of the morning fire, it seemed the right thing to do." "Grandmother, you've been telling me things I've never heard before," Dar said. "Why?" "You're about to become a man, Dar. It's time you learned about your beginnings." Mora got down from the boulder and picked up her lamp. "I'm going to sleep. Are you coming?" "Soon," Dar answered. He had a lot to think about and wanted to return to the tent after both his uncle and grandmother were asleep.